Today we're going to learn how to use Bias SoundSaver to record old LPs and cassettes. In the Start screen, click the New Recording button and name your recording. You can also choose to open a previous SoundSaver project for further editing. Before making a new recording, you'll have to first connect your audio source to your computer. See the included connection diagram for more information on cable connections. Once everything's connected, play the loudest part of your audio source and click the Auto Level button to set the proper input level. You can also set the level manually by adjusting the input level slider so that the loudest part of the audio you're recording falls between the two blue triangles that appear over the input level meters. When the recording level looks good, move to the Record page and click the Record button to get started. Start playback of your source from the beginning. Don't worry if you record some dead air, we can edit that out later. SoundSaver also has a record timer, so you can record for a specific length of time, perfect for capturing one side of a record or cassette. When you've recorded one side of your LP or cassette, click the Stop Pause button, flip the record or tape, and then click the Append button to continue recording. You can also simply let SoundSaver keep recording while you flip the LP or cassette. It's easy to edit that silence out later. If you're monitoring or listening as you record, you can drop in track markers between songs. You can also add these after recording. Depending on the audio content, you can use regular or contiguous track start and end markers. Regular markers define the start and end of a track. These are most often used when working with recordings of typical, commercially produced records and tapes, which have clearly defined silent areas between tracks. Contiguous markers are always positioned back-to-back and are used when marking tracks in continuous play DJ mixes, live concert recordings, and some classical music recordings, all of which generally flow from one song into the next with no distinct gap between them. SoundSaver even has a feature that lets you record old 78 RPM records on a 33 or 45 RPM turntable, and then adjust the speed so they sound right when you play the recording on your computer. To finish recording, click the Stop Pause button and move on to the Clean screen, where you can clean up clicks, crackles, hum, and hiss. Cleaning your recordings is optional. I've gone ahead and recorded this album already, so we can jump right into cleaning it up. Now I'll start playback and adjust the click and crackle dial until it's removing the clicks and crackles as desired. Use the lowest possible setting that eliminates them. To remove broadband noise like tape hiss, position the playhead in an area that contains just the noise you want to eliminate. Then start playback and click the Learn button. After about a second, SoundSaver identifies the frequencies that make up the noise, and noise reduction turns on automatically. To fine-tune the level of noise reduction, click the Noise button, and adjust the tuner dial until you hear just the unwanted noise. Then, go back to on mode and adjust the reduction dial to the desired level. Try to use the lowest possible setting that removes the noise. If your recording contains electrical hum, click the 50 or 60 Hz hum removal button. Use 60 Hz for recordings made in North America, and 50 Hz for recordings made in other parts of the world. If you're not sure which setting to use, try them both. One will remove the hum and the other won't. You can also use the Enhance control to boost the high or low frequencies that are often lost in recordings made from old worn out records and tapes. When you're happy with your settings, click the Apply button. Though we don't need it in this example, SoundSaver can also remove low-frequency rumble and preserve voice in vocal recordings. Let's move on to the Define Tracks page, where we can cut the recording into separate tracks, either automatically or manually. Both methods are useful, it really just depends on the audio content you're working with. If you've only recorded a single song, or simply prefer not to define separate tracks, you can move on to the Export screen. To use Automatic mode, just click the Automatically Define Tracks button. Try using the default settings first, as they work well on many types of audio content. The auto-defined track settings allow you to vary how the number of tracks and spaces between them are detected. Click OK to break up your recording into tracks. Zoom in so you can see the first track's end marker and the second track's start marker. These should appear back-to-back in the silent area between the first two songs. If they aren't in quite the right place, you can drag them forward or backward until they are. Or, you can fine-tune your auto-defined track settings for more accurate initial track detection. Depending on the audio in your settings, some areas may be detected as individual tracks when they're actually part of another track. These can easily be deleted, and the track's markers can be moved into the right positions. You can also define tracks manually by simply selecting part of the waveform and then clicking the Define Selection as New Track button. This is perfect for live concert recordings or continuous play DJ mixes, which have no track breaks for SoundSaver to detect. When working with this type of audio content, be sure that your track markers are placed back-to-back with no spaces between them. This will ensure uninterrupted playback between the separate tracks. With our tracks defined, we can now also name them, either manually by double-clicking the track's name in the song column, or we can get the artist's track and album info automatically from the internet. To retrieve track info from the internet, select any track and click the ID3 button. Then enter the artist or album name and click the Download Album Info button. If a match or multiple matches are found, select the right one and click the OK button to add the info to your tracks. Now we're almost done. Let's move to the export page and choose an output format. MP3 files can be imported into other programs or loaded onto portable media players and mobile phones. Exported MP3 files will include any ID3 tags you've added or downloaded from the internet. The iTunes export option is handy if you wish to transfer files to an iPod, iPad, or iPhone. Wave file export creates high-resolution uncompressed wave files, which can be burned to CD or used in other audio or video editing programs. Finally, you can also export a SoundSaver project file so you can edit it later or transfer it to another computer. Let's export this album to iTunes. When you're all done, just quit SoundSaver. It automatically saves your work as you go.